Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our morning worship and prayer. As we begin our time together, I would like for us to reflect on the psalmist in Psalm 11, verse 7. It says here, "For the Lord is righteous. He loves righteous deeds. The upright shall behold his face." Let's behold his face today and get ready to receive a fresh impartation of God's mercy and God's grace that sustains us even through the challenges that we are facing this day and this coming week. Let's join the music team in worship.
They curse and laugh, you do not fight. A thousand men yell, crucify. Crimson stains that fill your mind, you look upon me with delight. From throne to cross, you came to die. A crown for thorns to bring new life. With every nail I feel your beauty. What a beautiful love. What a beautiful love. What a beautiful love.
Praise God. Our passage for today is found in James chapter 1, verse 26 and 27. It says here, if anyone thinks he is religious and does not bridle his tongue, but deceives his heart, this person's religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their affliction and to keep oneself unstained from the world. We all know that Christianity is the world's largest and the most widespread religion. Christianity are estimated to make up a majority of the population in 157 countries and territories. Of course, familiar tayo that in Christianity, biblical Christianity, we usually refer to it as a relationship. But the Bible is also clear that Christianity is a religion. It is a system of faith and worship. It is a set of beliefs and practices. Yes, there are ceremonies. Yes, there are disciplines. But I believe it's good for us to know that the Bible is not really anti-religion. But what is very clear is that the Bible speaks of a religion that are worthless, meaning without purpose or groundless or without aim or vain. Now, in the passage that we looked at in James, this is actually written by the half-brother of Jesus. He was not one of the original 12, but eventually became one of the leaders and ended up leading even the Jerusalem church after the Lord's resurrection. Now, the book of James is popularly known as the Proverbs of the New Testament. So, theological, but also practical. And sometimes you might be wondering, dapat ba may mga books na more theological and books that are more practical but less theological? I think James would beg to disagree because James thinks that theology and practice should go together. In fact, James makes a case here in the passage that we read that it should be both. Of course, James, someone who first doubted the Lord Jesus Christ, eventually becoming a believer and a follower. He was such a pious person. In fact, according to church tradition, yung knees niya became so hard. It was described as camel knees because he constantly bended in worshiping God and asking forgiveness for God's people. In fact, in history, he became known as James the Just, and he gained a lot of influences, not only for the people who are outside of the church, but even among the Jewish people, even to this day. So according to Apostle James, there are two descriptions of what he calls true religion. And this is why I believe it's important that we also think of being socially responsible as a church because of these two reasons. First one, true religion is expressed with right words and the right works. In the passage that we read, okay, he was talking about how we should not bridle our tongue and not deceive our hearts because that would make religion worthless. And he would talk about visiting the orphans and the widows. So Paul was trying to James was telling us that the importance of hearing and doing. That it's important to hear the word, but also obey the word. But he was also giving us the importance of how our hearts and our hands should be involved in our faith. Of course, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So we have to learn how to control our tongue and what we say and how our words becomes a blessing to people. But it's not just with our words, but also with our actions. When we visit the widows, the orphans, the vulnerable, the oppressed, the afflicted, So that's why as a church, it's very important for us to not just exercise gospel proclamation, but also gospel demonstration through our Love the City efforts, through our real life when people are going through difficult circumstances, such as now, of course, we pray that you are all safe and your families are all doing well, especially in the areas that are most affected But as a church, as a people, it's also our responsibility that we will accompany our right words with the right works, so that people who may not end up believing what we say may end up being open that we might be speaking what is true because of the deeds that they see. True religion is expressed with the right words and the right works. Now, the second thing is that true religion is also expressed with personal consecration and practical compassion. Personal consecration and practical compassion. James was talking about how we are to be unstained from the world, how we are not to be influenced by the world in a negative way, not to be conformed to the patterns of the world, as Paul would say it. But at the same time, that we have to be acting it out with acts of compassion, with acts of mercy. And of course, we can imagine and we can remember how the Lord Jesus Christ did his earthly ministry. When the religious leaders of the day would not touch the broken, the unclean, because they are afraid that they will become clean, Jesus, the Holy One of Israel, the one who is truly clean, touched the unclean so that they can be made clean, so that the broken can be made whole. And of course, now that we have the Spirit of God, now that Christ dwells in us, we are also to do the same, that we are to engage our broken world, our broken surroundings, that we are to engage the community that is in need of healing and wholeness, and trusting that by the grace of God, that we will be the ones who can make that change, initiate the change, and not be changed by the world in the process. But if ever meron mang changes na nangyayari sa atin, hopefully it's becoming more and more compassionate towards them. It's becoming more and more not just believing the word, but living out the world as we relate with them. I pray that each and every one of us will grow in our relationship with God, but I also pray that we would all grow in exercising true religion, that we will practice speaking the right words and doing the right works, that we will grow in personal holiness. Tama-tama, set apart pa naman yung theme natin this year, but also growing more in our practical acts of kindness and compassion towards the people around us. We're going to worship the Lord once again, and as we do, I want us to reflect and ask the Lord to show us that maybe there are things that we have to change in the way we speak, and the things that we have to start doing so that we don't just proclaim the gospel, but also demonstrate the gospel to the people around us. And if you remember people or maybe places, especially now that are affected by the typhoon, I pray that you would also have the heart to think through and pray, Lord, how can we be a blessing to the people who are in need, to the people who are vulnerable, and the people that we need to visit, and the people that we need to get in touch with so that we could speak encouragement and life to them as they go through tough times. So let's worship the Lord once again, and let us prepare our hearts to receive maybe some word of guidance and encouragement from the Lord this morning.
So glorious, came down unashamed, you called me yours, caught up in your grace, your came down unashamed.
Why do we dedicate this day and the rest of the week in worship and prayer, believing for God to do great things in us as we follow Him and obey His word? Lord, we thank you, God, for the message that we've heard today. We first thank you, God, that you are the word that became flesh, dwelt among us, and the word that was fulfilled so that we can have the good news that in spite of the challenges that we are facing, Lord, that we have a great future in store for you, from you, Lord. And I pray, God, that you would empower us by your Spirit to keep proclaiming the gospel to everyone who needs it, but also, God, to demonstrate it, God, with acts of kindness, demonstrating your love, especially for those who are oppressed and in distress and those who are in challenging situations. Lord, we also lift up to you, Lord, yung mga kababayan namin, Lord, especially in places that are very much affected by the typhoon. Lord, may you send the help of the Holy Spirit to encourage them, to strengthen them during this time. And may you also use people, Lord God, even use us as a church so that we could be a blessing to those who are in need. Lord, not just in the Real Life Foundation that we have, but also, Lord, in the Love the City and when there are relief operations that are happening. Lord, we thank you, God, that you are raising us up to become a people who will not just receive your love and compassion, but a people who will become instruments of your love and compassion towards others as we become a more socially responsible people belonging to a socially responsible church. God, we thank you, Lord, for your grace that abounds and your grace that works in us and through us. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I hope you are blessed today, and I hope that we would all continue to be a blessing to the people around us. Have a great day and have a great week.